I will then move on to plant supports. These are kind of the secondary things that we do for our plants. You know, we provide them with, we prepare a good bed for them to grow in, we prepare the soil, we add organic matter to it, we mulch that to hold in moisture and to keep the soil cool and to provide additional organic matter to keep down weeds. We water properly in the right amount, and we fertilize. And that's kind of basic care for plants. But now some plants do need some secondary kinds of things, such as support. And this is sort of a, you know, a little bit more of a lighthearted kind of portion of the practices in gardening. But basically, you know, when you're looking at plants that have vining stems or plants that have weak stems, those often do need to have some support. Sometimes those weak stems are weak just because they're a very tall plant. Vining stems may actually have mechanisms to attach themselves to some sort of support, or maybe not. And so there are lots of different ways, lots of different structures and methods to use to provide that support. And I have a few of those things pictured here. Using string is a real basic way to provide support for all kinds of vining things, especially those that have twining tendrils or, like in the case of beans and peas, that can actually attach themselves to the string. Or wire for heavier woody stems like grapes. They have tendrils too that attach them to those wires, but it needs to be a heavier support because it's a heavier plant. Arbors and trellises, the obelisks there are a form of arbors. Arbors are usually three-dimensional, trellises are two-dimensional, and again, depending on whether something twines or has tendrils and can attach itself to its support or not, it will either need your assistance with that support or not. Up in the upper right-hand corner, those are some plant supports that have been constructed from tree branches, essentially. Those are hazelwood or hazelnut, and apparently grows quite readily in areas in Britain, and so they use a lot of these kinds of structures and supports in Britain. But any kind of stems or sticks that you want to use, reusing yard waste is a good way to use some of these branches and stuff that you've got left over as supports. One of my favorite ways is to do what's called pea stakes. And that is to take cut branches from trees that are very twiggy. So each of those branches has a main stem as the base, and then small branches going out to the tip of the cut section of branch. And what you do is you take several of these and you insert that straight end into the soil in several places around the emerging plant. And this can be done with peonies very easily. It can be done with clematis. It can be done with sweet pea vines. And I also do it with my Baptisia. So I put these supports in, and then as the emerging plants start to grow up and they work their way up through these twigs that I've placed in the ground, they end up growing in and amongst and around these twigs to the point where you end up not seeing the twigs at all, but the twigs are still there providing support. And I like your graphics there, Mike, adding that the green growth there really shows how this works. And I hardly use anything besides this for peonies anymore because it works so nicely. So reusing branches and such for supports, pea stakes is one way to do that. I also mentioned that with vines, sometimes they have structures that hold the plant onto whatever structure they're growing on. So there are holdfasts, there are tendrils, there are, in the case of clematis, it's actually the petiole of the leaf that is twining. And that twining petiole holds itself, wraps itself around whatever support it has. But sometimes that plant that you're trying to provide support for doesn't have anything to help support itself, and therefore you need to tie it. And a good way to do that is using a figure eight system like this, for a couple of reasons. One is that you will provide more friction here so that as the weight of the plant bears down on that tie, it doesn't make the tie slide all the way down the stick that you've got it tied to. And it also prevents there from being damage of the stem of the plant as it expands in girth, and as it lays up against the stem and rubs against it, you can damage the stem. So this helps to prevent that. So I find that these figure eight twist ties, or anything that you use, you can use pantyhose, knee-high stockings, little shredded pieces of a bed sheet, and then there's all sorts of fancy ties that you can purchase at the garden centers too. But I find that in any case, using it in a figure eight system like that seems to work quite nicely.